Hello guys and welcome back to another video from my YouTube channel, that is Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials. So your friend Vipin Sharma is currently available on India's largest learning platform, that is Unacademy. So to follow me on Unacademy, you can click on the link given in the description below, as well as you can watch all my lectures on molecular basis of inheritance. You can also download the Unacademy's education app from Google Play Store for better learning experience. Today we are going to continue our lecture on the structure of human respiratory system. और उसके बारे में कुछ इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्ट्स थे जो कि छूट गए थे लास्ट लेक्चर में, उनके बारे में आज हम डिटेल में बात करेंगे विद द हेल्प ऑफ अ डायग्राम गिवन इन एनसीईआरटी. सो दिस इज गोइंग टू बी द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ लंग्स. ओके, दिस इज द रेस्पिरेटरी पैसेज एंड दिस इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ लंग. वी आर नॉट मेकिंग बोथ ऑफ देम बिकॉज वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड द फिजियोलॉजी फ्रॉम अ सिंगल लंग ऑल्सो, राइट? सो द सेम काइंड ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर इज प्रेजेंट ऑन दिस साइड ऑल्सो, दैट्स व्हाई वी हैव मेड ओनली सिंगल वन, राइट? So this upper cartilaginous flap-like structure, okay, this is cartilaginous flap-like structure is known as epiglottis, okay, which used to close during swallowing process so that the food will not enter the voice box. And the voice box is also known as the larynx, which is also cartilaginous in nature, right? So we have talked about the passage of respiratory system, that it starts from the external nostril, then it will pass through the nasal passage to the nasal chamber, right? So after nostril there is nasal chamber, after that there is pharynx, which is the common passage for both food as well as air. After that there is going to be trachea, right? So this passage, this particular straight tube is going to be trachea. Okay, and this is quite long in nature. It is extended up to the mid thoracic level. Jo fifth thoracic vertebra hai, after its reachment, after its attainment, let's say this is fifth thoracic vertebra, after this level it will bifurcate into two sides, right and left. Okay, after that there is going to be the origination of primary bronchi, then there is going to be secondary bronchi, then tertiary bronchi, then initial bronchioles, then terminal bronchioles, and then finally alveoli. This is going to be the arrangement. So there may be primary bronchi, secondary bronchi, which are supported with the help of these incomplete rings. We have talked about the rings in last lecture, but we are viewing them now. Okay, so this is trachea. So I have a ring in my hand which is incomplete in nature. I put it here so that the trachea and all the important organs or ducts will not collapse. क्योंकि ये काफी क्या होती हैं, बहुत ही हल्की होती हैं, बहुत ही delicate होती हैं. They are very soft and they used to passage the air. Obviously they are going to be soft. So to support them we need some sort of rings, and those rings are present in the trachea up to the initial bronchioles. जो initial bronchioles हैं, terminal bronchioles में present नहीं होती. उससे पहले जितना भी रीजन है उसमें अप्रोक्सीमेटली हर जगह पे आपको ऐसे रिंग्स देखने को मिल जाएंगे, राइट? सो फ्रॉम दिस एक्सटर्नल नॉस्ट्रिल टू द लोअर पार्ट, ओके, टिल द टर्मिनल ब्रोंकियोलस क्या होता है, इट इज द कंडक्टिंग पाथ, राइट? इट इज द कंडक्टिंग पाथ मीन्स इट्स वर्क इज टू transport the air only. There will be no exchange taking place till here. Okay, after that there are some terminal structures. That terminal structures are having irregular boundaries. These were highly vascular bag like structure. Highly vascular means they do have blood supply and they are having very thin membrane, and these two three conditions are very very important for the diffusion process. That the membrane must be thin, क्योंकि जितनी ज्यादा thin होगी membrane उतनी ही ज्यादा permeable भी होगी. जितनी ज्यादा vascular होगी blood supply, it will increase the amount of diffusion or the gaseous exchange taking place. So the exchange portion, the exchange work will take place in the duct of alveoli and in the alveoli itself, right? So exchange part is alveoli and the ducts of alveoli, and other than that all the remaining parts which are present in the passage of human respiratory system are just working as a conducting system, are just working as a passage. They do not have any kind of role in the exchange of gases, because all of them are not that much permeable to gases, or these are not that much vascular, right? Just like alveoli, it has the thinnest wall present in this case, okay, as well as it is highly vascular. So alveoli or duct of alveoli gases exchange mein help karengi. Baki pura jo system hota hai use hum bolte hain conducting system. And since this part only works as the exchange pathway, so it is known as the exchanging system or exchanging part, right? So there will be this primary bronchi, then secondary bronchi, then let's say tertiary bronchi, then initial bronchioles, terminal bronchioles, and these are this balloon like structure which is present at the end. The terminal most part is going to be the alveoli, which is responsible for the gaseous exchange. Now the structure of lungs, these are lungs, we know that very well. These are surrounded by a membrane called pleura, okay, or pleural membrane, and that pleural membrane have two parts, one external membrane, one internal membrane. So there is a green part over here. So the external part is going to be the external pleural membrane, and the internal one is the internal pleural membrane. And the green portion is nothing but a fluid, which is known as pleural fluid, present in between the two layers of pleura. जो एक्स्ट्रा प्लूरा होगी, जो बाहर वाली प्लूरा जो लेयर होगी, दैट इज गोइंग टू बी इन कॉन्टैक्ट विद द थोरेसिक लाइनिंग. बट द इंटरनल प्लूरा, जो कि जाहिर सी बात है लंग की जो एक्स्ट्रा जो सरफेस है उसके साथ अटैच हो. ओके, सो द लंग इज कवर्ड विद टू वॉल्ड प्लूरल मेम्ब्रेन. द इनर वन इज इन कॉन्टैक्ट विद द सर्फेस ऑफ लंग, द आउटर वन इज गोइंग टू बी इन द सर्फेस ऑफ थोरेसिक लाइनिंग, राइट? So this is about the basic structure which is supported with the incomplete rings like structure. Okay, after that the passage or the conducting pathway of gases plays a very important role. There are certain regions which are present over here which used to purify the airs, okay, such as hairs present in the nasal passage, and there are different kind of cilia which are present which traps the particle with mucus. ओके, हमारी बॉडी में म्यूकस प्रेजेंट होता है इन द रेस्पिरेटरी लाइनिंग, जो कि अगर कोई एक्स्ट्रा पार्टिकल आता है, यानी कि पैथोजन और डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ डिजीज कॉजिंग माइक्रोब्स आर देयर, इट यूज्ड टू ट्रैप इट इन मोस्ट ऑफ द केसेस. ओके, इट यूज्ड टू ट्रैप इट, इट यूज्ड टू कवर इट विद म्यूकस, एंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ सिलिया इट यूज्ड टू थ्रो इट आउट ऑफ द बॉडी, बिकॉज सिलिया हेल्प्स इन द मोशन, राइट? सो इफ देयर इज एनी पार्टिकल, लेट्स से देयर इज अ पार्टिकल, देयर इज अ पैथोजन, दिस इज द पैथोजन, and this pathogen is now present in the respiratory tract, so it will be covered with the mucus present in the respiratory tract, and with the help of numerous cilia present over here, it will be, you know, moved to a particular direction that is going to be outside the body, and it will be expelled out of the body. So it will help us in immunity somehow. Okay, so it used to purify the air by removing different kind of dust particles, and it used to humidify the soil, humidify the air. So क्या होता है, humidify कर देता है, मतलब कि humidity बढ़ा देता है और उसको maintain कर सकता है. कोई pathogen अगर आया है तो उसको expel कर सकता है, कोई dust particle या फिर कोई भी ऐसी चीज आ गई जो air के साथ necessary नहीं है, it will expel it out, and it will also maintain the temperature so that the temperature of the gas will not vary that much. Okay, it will be up to a certain amount, it will be in accordance with our body temperature. ऐसा कुछ जो करता है, ये काम होता है transporting जो system है उसका, या जो conducting system है उसका, temperature को control करना, humidity को control करना, dust particles को remove करना, that is going to be the steps or that is going to be the work or function of this conducting pathway. After that, what? There will be exchange of gases taking place in the alveoli and depths of alveoli, because both of them are highly vascular and thin membrane. After that, the lungs are going to be airtight. Why? Because in the dorsal side, okay, in dorsal side, the vertebral column is present. In the ventral side, sternum is present. In the lateral side, some cut end of ribs are present like this, which are shown in NCRT. And in the lower side, this is the diaphragm. Okay, this is the diaphragm. So it is totally packed from all the side. If I am a lung, let's suppose I am a lung. So from the dorsal side, I am covered with the vertebral column. In the ventral side, I am covered with the sternum. In lower side, I am covered with what? Diaphragm. And on the lateral side, I am covered with the ribs. So I am totally packed now. Okay. And this airtight condition is very important for the lungs to function properly. Otherwise, any little change can, you know, change the volume of lung. Okay. कोई भी चीज जो है छोटे मोटे जो चीज भी है वो भी volume को change कर सकती है. And that is going to be very harmful for the gaseous exchange. So it is airtight. Okay, very tight because it is covered from all the ways with different kind of organs. Then what are the steps in the gaseous exchange? We are going to deal with it with mechanism. Okay, वहाँ पर हम डिटेल में बात करेंगे. यहाँ पर मैं आपको ओवरव्यू दे देता हूँ. If you are able to got this overview very clearly, you can easily understand the whole respiration process like this. So listen to it very carefully. I'll give you a lecture on it separately, but just listen to me right now. Okay. So what is the process of respiration? You are going to inhale the gas, right? So from the external nostril or from mouth, I have taken gas inside my body. Now that gas will cover the whole respiratory passage and it will finally lead to the alveoli. Okay. Now the oxygen concentration is higher in alveoli because we have inhaled oxygen, right? So oxygen concentration is higher in alveoli. Now hundreds of thousands of metabolic reactions are taking place in our tissues or cells, right? And the metabolic reactions used to produce CO2. That CO2 will be higher in case of tissues or cell. Okay, jo CO2 hai, this will be higher in tissues or cell. So what is the basic mechanism of respiration? That we have to exchange O2 with CO2. So these gases can also be transported with the help of blood supply, so that the oxygen that we take inside our body will be transferred to all the different organs with the help of blood supply. And wahan par kya hoga? Since this O2 is exchanged, right? So yahan par kya hoga? O2 zyada hai alveoli mein. Alveoli do have O2 and the external environment will have CO2. Why it will have high CO2? Because let's suppose there is a cell and the cell will produce CO2 due to metabolic reactions. This CO2 will be transported via blood near the alveoli because it is always circulating. Okay, so it will be in the blood flow. Now here the concentration of CO2 is more in the blood because it is taking blood from the cell which is producing CO2. So according to the law of diffusion, O2 will move from its higher concentration to the lower concentration. So now it will be present in the blood. That O2 is carried by the blood to the cell again. And a reverse case in which the CO2 that is produced by the cell, taken by the blood flow to the alveoli, will go from its higher concentration to the lower concentration. Because CO2 is low in alveoli. In alveoli, O2 is maximum, right? So CO2 will go from the blood flow to the alveoli. Now let's talk about the alveoli and environment. In environment, we know that there is approximately 21% oxygen, which is specifically 20.8% or something like that. But CO2 is quite less. It is not even a single percent. 1% bhi nahi hai CO2. So in environment, CO2 is less, oxygen is more. And in alveoli right now, CO2 is more. Why? Because it have taken CO2 from the cell or from the blood flow and it has given its oxygen. So now CO2 is more in alveoli, CO2 is less in environment. So the CO2 will move from alveoli to the environment and the fresh oxygen will come from environment to the alveoli. Then from alveoli, the oxygen will go to the tissues with the help of blood circulatory system, and the CO2 will be taken from blood circulatory system from the cells and it will be transported to alveoli. Then alveoli se environment, environment se alveoli, alveoli se cell, cell se dubara alveoli. दिस टाइप ऑफ साइकिल्स कीप ऑन रिपीटिंग सेवरल टाइम्स, और आपको क्या है कंटिन्यूअस ऑक्सीजन सप्लाई मिलती रहती है. दिस इज द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन. इफ यू आर एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड इवन अ बिट ऑफ इट, विच आई थिंक दैट आई हैव सिंप्लीफाइड इट इन अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग मैनर, अगर आप लोगों को ये चार बातें समझ में आ गई तो ये पूरा चैप्टर क्लियर हो जाएगा बड़ी ही आसानी से. ट्रस्ट मी ऑन दैट. द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर इज गोइंग टू बी अबाउट द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ ब्रीदिंग, इन विच वी विल शॉर्टली टॉक अबाउट द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ गैसियस एक्सचेंज एंड वट इज द चेंजेस इन लंग्स वॉल्यूम एंड डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स लाइक दैट. तो अगर आपको आज का लेक्चर पसंद आया देन डू हिट लाइक बटन, एंड इफ यू आर वॉचिंग माई वीडियो फॉर द वेरी फर्स्ट टाइम देन रिकमेंड माई चैनल टू योर फ्रेंड्स एंड शेयर माई वीडियोज. थैंक यू सो मच.